had that much time to play with him yet in the OPL, but in the games he has played, he's looked quite good. So, I mean, Siv is a big pick for both these teams. It wouldn't surprise me at all to see it contested somewhere in the picks. But
yeah.
Immunity, they look comfortable on the last drive. I think just strategically misplayed slightly against the Chiefs. They'll play that again if they have it, but if they get Siver, they're absolutely playing it.
Yeah, and the fact that Uberbro looks so fantastic in lane as well on that Jinx means that the Siver pick, a little bit more difficult to make comfortably, you have to think. But Energizer, I mean, he played with Sudden Fear during the OCS. He played a lot of Ezreal, actually, during that particular tournament, so managed to pick up a couple of victories on that one and see whether that could be an option as well. But you have to think that if the Siver is available, they're going to go for it.
Yeah, we'll have to see. We're pretty deep in the draft. Sudden Fear have one more ban left, so we'll see what Immunity want to take for their first pick.
Yeah, and Lissandra being taken away, and there is the respect, Swain. Always have to respect the Birdman. This is the first time we've seen it banned away from Cheese thus far in the OPL.
Yeah, I mean, he's drawn bans classically in tournaments for quite a while, but yeah, finally, especially Sudden Fear, like you mentioned, don't want to have flashbacks of their last game here. And this is a rematch. That's probably the other important thing. We're starting to see teams play each other multiple times. They play each other twice in a best of one, so this is the second one here, and I'm curious to see how Sudden Fear have adjusted between the last game.
And they've adjusted by leaving Kassadin open.
I mean, banning Swain makes sense, though. I mean, Kassadin's a great pick here. I was actually a big fan of Cheese's Kassadin in the last game.
He was very strong. Just unfortunately out-rotated, as you mentioned, but you have to think that the laning phase was fantastic. And, I mean, Apaps, we've seen him on a lot of these mages that he's very comfortable on, but how do you think about Kassadin versus the Xerath here, which could be possibly coming through?
I actually quite like the matchup for Xerath. It's fairly safe. Kassadin, again, is a surprisingly safe laner in the mid just because of how his Q works against mages. A little more awkward against ADs, but most of the ADs are melee, so you can push them out with Force Pulse. So you get a lot of good push and pull in most of your lanes. Xerath will be a fine pick here for Paps, but Kassadin, that's sort of the thing. He's safe, but he's not oppressive. You can pick almost anything into him.
And Christmas Trees, of course, being Christmas Trees, going to lock away that Gnar. This guy is probably one of the scariest Gnars in solo queue, just in general. But him in a team fight is just beautiful to watch, despite the fact that he's been a little bit nerfed here. And they are going to get the Siver as well. So we might just see Sudden Fear saying, all right, it worked that time. Let's just do it every single time.
And that makes sense. I mean, we almost criticized Immunity for doing that before because they always love to play these Siver-based comps. Sudden Fear, why not play what you're comfortable with? I mean, it's not like it's bad. Siver's a really good champion, and so is Gnar. And Christmas Trees is a great Gnar player, so I like these first two pickups here, but I have got plenty of space now.
So many options, and Zahi going to just hop on his very comfortable J4. Hop, take that one into the jungle, of course. Can be in the top lane, JK Smithy, of course, with a huge, gigantic champion pool, able to play that one if he feels like it, but you have to think that Zahi, more than comfortable on that one, actually has picked up two of their three victories on that champion.
Yeah, I mean, just such a strong Jarvan player. It's funny that Lee Sin feels like it's dropped off a little, but I guess Jarvan's just has much more to offer from the jungle, even though they're relatively similar champions. So I like that here for Zahi and Immunity. They've done it before, and they're going to do it again. T-Gun, not going to go for the engage support this time.
Nope, and again, you know, the Sudden Fear trash talk over Twitter from a few weeks ago is once again going to be answered by T-Gun. Just say, I can just do this all day. Back it up.
In Sudden Fear's defense, after that game, they were they kind of retracted some of those statements. Like, oh, sorry, T-Gun, you are good at Janna.
Yes,
bow
before your lord. Yes, indeed. But Apaps looking at a Riven, probably not going to come through. And you mentioned Lee Sin. A Pink Bomi could be picking that one up. And that Nidalee is actually banned towards a Pink Bomi almost 100%. Actually, Christmas Trees plays that a lot in the top lane, but Pink Bomi also been picking that one up a lot as well. They're not going to be seeing that on the Rift, and we'll see whether his Lee Sin can stand up to it.
Yeah, it's actually an APAP champion as well, so across the board for Sudden Fear boys. So they got lots of options here. I would love, and we do see a Brawler. That's a big statement against a player like T-Gun.
And this is how Brawler managed to pick up their victory in their last matchup. They were using this Siver Blitzcrank lane and getting the hooks and capitalizing on beautiful play. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah, I mean, Brawler's a great Blitzcrank player. It's hilarious to me that he's doing this against T-Gun, who is possibly
who's now playing Janna.
Who's the Blitzcrank player as far as Oceanic players go. He's renowned for that play. He used to hover it every single game and hasn't done it so this time. So maybe he's like, man, am I getting talented here? Are they picking Blitz against me, really?
I actually find it hilarious because you've got just T-Gun in general. He epitomizes these engaged supports. Even his Morgana, he picks it as an engaged champion. His Thresh as well is fantastic. Brawler, he's known for playing Lulu. He's that disengage heavy. Lulu, Nami, Janna, like, they're his champions, and now he's like, not playing Blitzcrank. Don't even worry.
Yeah, I think he must have a soft spot for the champion there as well. Because this is a second outing, and you said it. They got a win on it. Why not play it again?
Yeah. That's true. And JK Smithy looking at picking up the Renekton once more. Did fantastically in lane, you have to say, but just wasn't quite the late game force that I guess you don't expect really from a Renekton just in general anyway. And Uber Bro, his first outing on Kalista.
Yeah, I'm sure he's played it. I don't think he's played it in the OPL. So
not
I
yet in the OPL, no.
Not yet, but I mean, it's a great champion here. It's funny to me that they pick Renekton when they have the Kalista, because you often take Renekton against her because she can't bust tank blast very well. Sivir, by the same token, also can't, so that does make some sense. But JK Smith is Renekton. Renekton's still a very good laner, and as long as he goes tanky, he's such a good one-man frontline.
Oh, yeah, that as well as the fact that the gank squad to come through from Zahi and JK Smithy, especially in that top side. I mean, Christmas Trees, I mean, I know he's got the bounce available that is a fantastic escape tool, but he may not be able to go far enough.
Yeah, and Apaps taunting us a little bit there, perhaps with some hovers.
Papaps!
He's going to take the matchup he thought
he's
he would.
Got it. He's got it, and the Xerath going to be taken into the shorter range Kassadin here, and you have to think that she's going to be in a little bit of trouble as far as the first few levels are concerned, but he might have an easier lane because, of course, Xerath just sits back and throws out Arcano Pulses and says, I just want to kill minions.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of just a farm fest, right?
Yeah.
You don't really want to do anything else. That's fine for Cheese, but I think Paps will take it as well. It actually fits fairly well with the way their comp works out.
Yeah.
Siv is really good with Xerath, and if you're trying to find picks, Xerath is surprisingly good in those situations, because either you have a great stun you can follow up with on your E, or you can zone everybody out with your W and E and make sure you ensure the pick and then move in 5v4. So I like it in the comp that they've built. Little low on damage potentially, so Sudden Fear have a lot riding on Blitzcrank picking people off or really good flanks from Lee Sin and Gnar.
Yeah, well, that's right. And, you know, Rite of the Arcane does have a huge range as well, so I guess if anything started sort of across the map, but is there sort of too much displacement to come through as well? Because you have to think that the members of Sudden Fear could sort of get in the way of Apaps here, because they could be gnarring people away, they could be grabbing them out of the way, they can be kicking them out of the way. Like, it's going to be players flying everywhere.
I mean, yeah, absolutely, but they kind of need it, honestly. They can't realistically fight big 5v5 teamfights with this comp. We often see Sivir paired with big high damage mages. Hi, Cheese. How are you? How's your swing? Ban this game, apparently.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's clearly not something that Sudden Fear plays, so they go with the comfort for Apaps on Xerath. So they have to play differently. They have to split fights up, pick people off with all of their good CC, because if they ever fight 5v5, especially against Renekton, Jarvan, just Renekton, Jarvan, Kalista, Kassadin is pretty gross.
Yeah, it's just a little bit dangerous to deal with. And we're talking about the likes of Swain. I mean, there are statistics out there that state that if Cheese isn't on Swain, things get a little bit more difficult for Team Immunity, because of course his stats on that champion are fantastic, but if he's on anything else, it goes down drastically.
Yeah, his KDA is actually pretty radically different. I mean, Immunity right now, before coming into this week, they were even as far as their record goes. So 50% win rate, not bad. But Swain's Cheese's KDA, sorry, on Swain versus not Swain was something like 5-ish.
Yeah, 5.3 versus 2.8 or something
like
that.
Yeah, there was almost a 50% drop in his KDA. So he's clearly very comfortable on the champion. It is a pick he's known for. It is a pocket pick for him. He's on a different champion this time, but I was very impressed with his Kassadin versus Chiefs.
Yeah, and his Kassadin has sort of always been very strong here as well. I mean, one of those comfort picks that we talk about there is sort of that 1-4 with Xerath, only sort of recently coming through at the end of last year, but it was always sort of Kassadin, Orianna, and of course that Swain that came through for Cheese. But this was back when Kassadin was just exceptionally broken, and you're going to pick it up at any point anyway.
I mean, Kassadin's really good right now as well. It's funny.
Yeah.
We're not going to see that much more Kassadin once the patch change is over, because players might still play him, but 450 is not a big Rift Walk range.
No.
But right now, Kassadin's still at full power. Makes sense that Immunity have a lot invested in it as far as first picks goes. They've first picked it twice now in two different games. If anyone's going to come up big here, it is going to be Cheese, but I'm quite excited for Uber Bros Kalista as well.
I'm excited for Uber Bros Kalista, and didn't play it once in the OCS, hasn't played it yet in the OPL, has played it a bit in the solo queue, but that's, you know, neither here nor there, because of course you can't judge it off that, and we'll see how he does bring in Kalista into competitive play. And the thing that I love about this, right, Fate's Call means that T-Gun can be an engaged support on any support that he's on.
Well, it's funny that you mentioned it. I'm sure that will happen every now and then. I think Uber Bros may be sad that the like pop out portion of Fate's Call is not up to him, it's up to T-Gun.
So
You could.
I'm saving you, T-Gun. I'm back in, buddy.
Exactly. But you can actually save supports with it. It's one of those things where everyone saw Kalista, like, that's a really cool ability. What can I do with it? And a lot of Annie, Morgana, and even Leona and Thresh to some extent as well. These were the sort of champions that people were playing with Kalista's ulti. But if you just take a big heal support like Janna, and just give her a free reposition tool with your ulti, you can make sure you're always standing in the right spot to peel for your team.
Not to mention, they can now Fates Call Monsoon someone back into the team. So, theoretically, he can be Brawler as well, as he can sort of move someone into his team like a hook. Like, I don't know. I'm trying to work out how he can get back.
To be fair, Tegan is one of the better Jannas aggressively using his ultimate. So, I wouldn't be too surprised to see him do that. I mean, it's funny that we joke about Tegan being an aggressive support. You know, he loves his Blitz, loves his Thresh, but he's a fine Janna player, but he's definitely a bit more aggressive on the champion than some other support players.
Oh, yeah. He's incredibly aggressive. But it works out so beautifully here for immunity. And thus far, I mean, it was paired with Little Cutie Cheese, or with Cheese, on his Swain. And now that he doesn't have it, is it going to be sort of as important to have that Janna in this particular team comp?
I actually really like Janna just in general when you're protecting big carry champions. Kassadin is a hyper carry as far as mid lane mages or mages go, whether they're top or mid. So actually being able to peel for your Kassadin sounds kind of weird. But if he gets in, Force Pulses, hits his Zhonya's, then goes back in, you want to make sure he can keep jumping on people. Because the longer he's alive, the more damage he does, right? Especially as he builds up stacks of his ulti. So I do like it here. It feels a bit wonky, but it does work. And Tegan basically protects two very good mobile hyper carries in this comp.
Yeah, and of course, Kalista as well, just so huge in these fights if he manages to get, especially that shield coming through, but the movement speed as well, and having Janna there with that Monsoon available just to keep him healthy. What with Monsoon and having double lifesteal items, I mean, that Kalista's just going to have so much regen.
Yeah, and that's why we've started seeing more Janna Kalista. We used to see, again, aggressive supports paired with Kalista, but if you can keep Kalista alive, she does so much work, and Janna is probably the single best support at keeping a hyper carry alive.
Oh, most definitely. But let's get into the game, ladies and gentlemen, as Immunity take on Sudden Fear yet again on the Rift. And Immunity, we'll see whether they can do it again or whether Sudden Fear can answer back this time.
Yeah, Sudden Fear definitely have a bit of momentum. They've started winning games here in the OPL. They've looked stronger. Brawler, I love this comfort pick for him as well. And we were going to highlight a matchup, it actually might be the bottom lane here. Brawler going in. Oh,
jeez. Didn't see it. Didn't juke it, but Brawler didn't hit it.
Yeah, I mean, just maybe even just out of range here as well on the Blitz, but I like it from Sudden Fear. They have a Blitzcrank. Blitzcrank really only does one thing, so you better get aggressive at level one.
Oh, most definitely. But Zahi, going to pop a ward down, spot Christmas Trees out, being a little dinosaur.
And I think Christmas Trees now actually is one of the more important things to highlight in this team comp. Meganar is an unbelievably good champion, but of course the drawback is that you can't be Meganar all the time. That would be very silly, so Sudden Fear really have to time their engages properly with Gnar, because if Christmas Trees isn't Mega Gnar, or if he times it incorrectly and they can't get a good fight off, Kalista will run wild in this team comp, because there are no other tanks on Sudden Fear's side.
Oh yeah, unless a pink Bomi can pick up like 17 kills in the first 7 minutes or something like that and build a Warmog upright. I don't know. Not entirely sure what he can do, but it is going to be the cloth 5-star coming through from Christmas Trees, really respecting J.K. Smithy's early pressure.
Yeah, and you have to respect Renekt, and we already saw him really walk over Swiper's Maokai in the laning phase at least here. And Gnar, for all of his strength as a laner, can't really stand up to a classic bully like Renekt.
Yeah, despite that hyper giving him the movement speed around, but it's going to be a pink Bomi starting on his Gromp here. It's going to be Gromp start here on the opposite side of the map as well. So jungle is going to be appearing out of this jungle on opposite sides, and we'll see whether this is because a pink Bomi wants to really try and keep down J.K. Smithy in this top side of the map.
It's not a bad spot to look for your first gank as well. Zahi also has options, but in general, Immunity really want to play their lanes fairly safe. Both Uberbro and Cheese have to just take their time in their lanes and make sure they stay alive and take their farm. J.K. Smithy can get creative, but he's kind of just looking to split his lane, and once Immunity get to the first, you know, first and second dragon fights, that's when they really want to start putting pressure on.
Yeah, and Sudden Fear, I mean, I think they're probably almost all in on that first one. As soon as Sivir gets her ultimate, I mean, they want to be hunting for champions and getting Christmas Trees right into this fight exactly where he wants to be. And the fact that you can time the on the hunt with the fact that Christmas Trees is getting that evolution very soon, and he's so good at making sure he has it at the right times, things could work out very, very well here for Sudden Fear, and we'll see whether they can orchestrate it correctly, because we know that when they do manage to get it right, it looks beautiful.
And it's funny that I talk about Meganar being such a good champion, and he is, but one of the disadvantages about always being Meganar, if that theoretically was the thing, is that Mininar bouncing into Meganar form actually gets a massive gap closer. So if you're able to combo that with Sivir's ulti, you can do insanely long distance engages with a great teamfight ulti and good follow-up CC. So again, it's a lot on Brawler getting picks or Energizer and Christmas Trees keeping all their abilities together so they can make sure they win the teamfights.
Yeah, but Uberbro on this Kalista going to be able to dance out of the way of some of these hooks, you have to think, keep himself in the positions that he wants to be, and we'll see whether Brawler can manage to get those picks, because of course, yeah, sort of across the board, everyone having options in order to save themselves from potential hook situations.
I think Kalista is really interesting against Skillshot champions. I think I'm going to give full credit to Rosie here, playing Leona against Kalista. Had a fantastic showing, but actually Christmas Trees and Pink Bomi going in.
Yeah, we mentioned he might be up here, but Slice and Dice going to come through, and JK Smithy more than safe.
That Minding Wave arriving very fortunately there for JK Smithy, able to not only slice and dice through it, but defend himself from the Q there. So good pressure by Pink Bomi, but no summoners unfortunately they've gotten.
Yeah, not going to happen, but Pink Bomi has made his way through this jungle very effectively at 11-8 in the farm as well, so not going to cost him too much here appearing in the top side of the map, and going to relieve Christmas Trees just a little bit.
Yeah, we pop in, actually, never mind.
Oh,
Zahi
on the bottom side does make his way through, gets rocket grabbed, but Brawler maybe shouldn't have done that because it put him a little bit further in range of Energizer. But Immunity not going to pick up anything here on the bottom side, so two sort of failed ganks here on either side of the map, but it was actually a flash picked up there on the bottom.
Yeah, I mean, flash forced out there, good pressure by Zahi, but smart hook actually by Brawler, basically just saying, I have to CC Jarvan. This is the one thing that people forget about Jarvan. For all the things he does, one of the things he does do is damage.
Yeah.
So you can't afford Jarvan to free hit your inner 3v2 situation, so a smart play by Brawler just to get Jarvan off.
JK Smithy going to use that full rage bar in order to get a whole bunch of his health back, but Hyper going to be used from Christmas Trees, and he's now a big dinosaur.
Yeah, I mean, this is a kind of an interesting battle. Meganar versus Renekton. I'm not too sure who wins, but Renekton is just so good at fighting, especially in creep waves, like you just saw with the Kaldameek, that JK Smithy just feels so comfortable pretty much in any current top lane matchup, it seems.
Oh, yeah. Just Renekton in general is just so awful to deal with if you're there on the top side of the map. But Christmas Tree's a very, very practiced Gnar player, and he's only down a few CS, so still able to put the pressure on. Trailblaze is going to be picked up by both of our junglers. Of course, you can still switch them over for nothing, so we'll see whether they go into a potential Skirmisher's Saber, as we've been seeing picked up by a lot of Jarvans, or maybe even that Chilling Smite option for a Pink Bomi.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised to not see Bomi pick it up, actually. I feel like he does want to try and get more aggressive, but maybe he just, you know, thinks the same thing. My team's going to mostly win around early mid-game fights, so I'm going to prepare and make sure I get there so that when we fight, you know, it's 3v3, 4v4, maybe even 5v5, I'm the most prepared to make that situation work.
And actually, Brawler not playing up very far here. They're just more than happy to sit and wait for this creep wave. Is this how you should be utilizing this this Blitzcrank comp?
I mean, this is one of the annoying things about Kalista. Oh, good
cook,
though.
Oh my goodness, that hook was incredible. Uberbro takes a hit for it. The boomerang to come through as well. But able to get out using that auto attack in order to displace his range enough. And let's have a look at that sweet hook. That was beautiful. Thank you very much for the replay.
That was really sweet. I mean, like, you can tell that Brawler's played Blitzcrank a few times, it seems like. Used the edge of that hitbox just beautifully. And this is, again, something I was crediting Rosie from the Chiefs for earlier. He hit skill shots so well from Leona onto Kalista. And the thing is, Martial Poise locks you into your auto attack. So if you either guess correctly or you're very fast as far as your skill shots go, Kalista's movement, despite being rapid, is very predictable.
Oh, yeah. So he's managed to land his first hook. We'll see whether he can land it the next time and get the knockup maybe even before she can dance her way out. Zahi looking for APAPs here, is coming around, does get a ward in. Zahi's jig is going to be up as he just retreats from the mid lane.
Yeah, I mean, he did get Uberbro's flash there to sort of answer your earlier question. So
that was
what I got at. But Blitzcrank's sort of in this unfortunate zone where the time where you're able to flash out of hook is nowhere close to Blitzcrank's auto attack range. So you can you can't naturally complete that combo very easily. And probably for the best, because it's really good.
Oh, yeah. And if you can, although if you manage to get the silence early enough,
so your ulti allows you to combo it so you can make sure to lock it down. Blitzcrank is, you know, a train of CC. You won't see him that much, so people forget, but
he kind of looks like a train,
he
too.
He does. Not quite Nautilus tier, but he does have a lot of CC.
Yeah, Pink Bomi is going to spot the fact that a Cheeky Dragon was attempted here from Immunity. They are going to lose their Pink Ward here by the pit as well, you have to think, as Brawler hanging around as well. Allengale just going to wake the dragon up again. He gets a little bit annoyed at Pink Bomi, but he's going to be able to get out of here just fine. And the battle for vision now won fairly effectively.
Good work cleared out there as well, but it looks like Energizer might be in trouble. Uberbro getting so aggressive on this Kalista.
Yeah, he's going down quite low, but Energizer is definitely lower. They managed to get the heal out of him as well as Uberbro manages to hold on to his. And despite the BF sword in comparison to the dagger Vampiric Scepter, Energizer still forced out.
Yeah, and this is part of the issue, really. Like, what is Uber Bro realistically afraid of here? Because if Blitz doesn't land a hook, he has nothing to worry about in this lane. And we see this a lot, actually, in Kalista Sivir lanes, where, yes, Sivir is very good at free-pushing you, but if you ever go into an actual fight, either 1v1 or 2v2, you're both short-range AD carry, but Kalista just does so much damage with Ren that Sivir can never commit to that. So this is what happens. You have to play back.
Yeah, and he certainly is at this stage. 62 to 68, though, so still staying up in that farm quite well, and with the extra utility that you do get out of a Sivir, can't be too bad here for Sudden Fear, but are they going to try and accelerate the teamfight phase of this game?
I mean, Sudden Fear are pretty comfy right now. Brawl, though, looking to go in.
Yeah, he's looking for it. A pink Bomi is coming around, gets spotted by a Sentinel, but Christmas Trees comes in, and First Blood goes down. Uber Bro's dead. Sudden Fear have four members. More than happily pick up that kill.
And you asked me, you know, does Sudden Fear want to accelerate the pace of the game? Answer is yes.
Yeah. Look at that. There it is. The teleport coming in. Easily pick up a kill. There is a ward in the back of this dragon pit. Sudden Fear not looking to pick that one up. And actually, Christmas Tree is going to head back to base. Do you think they had an opportunity, or are they trying to protect that outer turret in the top lane? But Cheese does die, but manages to pick up the kill into Apaps.
You know what? It's funny that you mentioned, although actually Brawler going into Zahi now.
Yeah, he's going to get kicked in the head. There's the safeguard to a minion. Zahi gets slowed by the red buff, and a pink Bomi just waits and waits and waits and takes his time, picks up the kill.
And you know what? If Sudden Fear don't get the dragon here, Acilia's immunity might look getting maybe a bit too aggressive in the jungle and mid. Sudden Fear wasted so much time that Kalista's back now after getting first blooded, and Sudden Fear moved Christmas Trees down to take the dragon and just walked back to top lane.
Yeah. Didn't lose the top out of turret though, but now starting up the dragon seems very, very dangerous. Christmas Trees has found his way back around, and it might have been due to the fact that they wanted to wait for that Meganar time, and now they can use the dragon, build up that rage. They've got level 6 on this this Sivir as well, as JK Smithy's coming in. They do manage to secure the dragon. T-Gun's here as well, looking for that Monsoon. He does split up a few members. Cheese finds his way back in. A pink Bomi is so low, but somehow survives. Apaps comes in, gets the stun here as well, as JK Smithy loses half his health. And the disengage is successful, almost, here by Sudden Fear. But Zahi, look at the Cataclysm onto two members. Both of them are going to die. A double kill for Cheese's Kassadin. And Christmas Tree's forced to get out. They didn't have to do that. It looked like they were sort of waiting to re-engage or something on the side of Sudden Fear.
I mean, that was the problem. When Sudden Fear didn't move, didn't take the dragon immediately after getting first blood, Immunity had so much time to line up a contestant. Sure, they lost the first dragon, but they'll take it. They had plenty of time to get everyone back together, hit their ultis, and then Sudden Fear just couldn't afford to wait as long as they did for that dragon. So they either get the kill and go for it, or get the rest of the kills and leave.
Yeah, and it's now 11 and a half minutes into this game, and Cheese has 3 kills, 1 death, and almost a completed Rod of Ages here as well. So things looking really, really scary. He's also got a gigantic CS lead in the mid lane.
Yeah, Cheese's Kassadin, again, has been so impressive so far. He actually does have enough to go get his Rod of Ages, and he's had stellar Rod of Ages timing throughout this entire day, both in the first game against Chiefs and this one now. He's going to stay for a little while longer because he's not delaying it too much by waiting a minute or two from this point, but that's what happens when Kassadin gets involved like that. Immunity have so many good ways to enable their carries, and Cheese just ran over that fight at Dragon.
Oh, yeah, he did. Now at 12 minutes, he's actually 1,200 gold in the lead. So with the clock on that one, as it were. There's the Gnar into the wall, though. JK Smithy gets kicked back towards the enemy tower. The slice and dice not going to cover quite enough distance, but Meganar just trying to get there, doesn't quite do it, and my gosh, the second time that's happened with a minion.
Yeah, so smart. Flashes past his minion wave, knowing that the Q's coming, and unfortunately for Sudden Fear, it was a great CC chain. They had Christmas Trees gnaw him, then a wallop, and then he got kicked out back away from the minion line. That was unfortunately a little too close that let him slice and dice out.
So still manages to use his Renekton slipperiness in order to get out. But you have to think Christmas Trees does have an opportunity to get back in this lane. Although he's just gone back to base and JK Smithy's still hanging around. So not even going to happen. Just that lead probably going to extend here from JK Smithy.
I mean, Gnar's fine with what's happening now. It's not a massive lead. Christmas Trees has almost got his Randuin, so he's comfortable at this point. But the fact that Pink Bomi visited that lane twice and neither time they couldn't quite get a kill, Christmas Trees probably feels a bit robbed after that, because they played that last engage perfectly and it still wasn't enough to kill Renekton.
Yeah, Uber Bro not able to finish off his Hurricane just yet. does have that CS advantage, but now with Sivir having an extra kill, you have to think going to be in the lead by just a little bit. Doesn't have the Infinity Edge yet, and is that Hurricane Spike with the Vampiric Scepter a little bit larger than just the Infinity Edge?
As far as Groove Infinity goes, that's actually an interesting question. For me, I feel like Kalista's first item, Hurricane, is all about transitioning to your second item. That's when you're really strong as Kalista. Kalista's in a duel, no, because Kalista's going to beat Sivir anyway in a duel. Although Brawler's going to try and make it a bit uneven.
He is. He's just powering through here. T-Gun looking to come through and make everything okay. Energizer getting caught up. There's the exhaust coming through as well. Monsoon just to disengage, but T-Gun taking so much damage. Energizer, oh my gosh, the Fates call. This is what we were talking about. Just save him. Oh, is the Ride of the Arcane going to be enough? Definitely not. He actually gives up on it.
Yeah, I mean, T-Gun had a shield there for himself as well, so it would have taken two bolts minimum to kill him there, and Apeps unfortunately missed the first two, so couldn't get the kill into T-Gun. Smart bait almost by T-Gun, I think, knowing the ulti was there, wanted them to go a little closer, but you can see 1v1 without Hurricane especially. Energizer does very good in a 2v2 here.
Yeah, looking fantastic. Brawler didn't even quite manage to close the distance that he wanted to. Of course, T-Gun sort of turning up at the nick of time in that bottom side, and Uber Bro now just going to clear out this wave. That Vamp Scepter doing a lot of work, helping keep him safe, but Energizer is still doing absolutely fine in this lane. It's very, very even across the board.
Yeah, smart clearing of the ward there as well by T-Gun, protecting his pink, and I guess to thinking about your last question, but as Hurricane bursts Infinity Edge a little more, I think it actually does favor Sivir at that point in time, just because the raw damage output between short range AD carries is so much. Sure, if the fight goes on too long, you'll die to rend eventually, but kind of the whole point with critting them is that they die very quickly.
Yeah. But see whether it does come through.
But as far as two items go, no. Then it just, that's awful. Kalista with two items is really scary.
I think it almost for anyone.
Yeah.
That's just awful.
And it only gets better from there. And actually, Uberbro's going to take a different tactic. This is much more duelist oriented.
Yeah. Uberbro going for something very strange. This is what we saw from CNJ, actually, on the side of Fortnite. But not going for sort of the extra AoE potential, but going for that single target dueling potential.
So I call Hurricane a transition item, and this build weirdly kind of accomplishes the same thing. Blade of the Ruined King is just much safer as a first item. Hurricane is a good item to speed you to your next item, but it's kind of risky. So Blade of the Ruined King Hurricane is very safe, but you don't do nearly as much damage with the two item power spike. So Uberbro is basically saying, I like where our team's sitting at right now. I'm probably happy where my Kassadin is especially. I feel like Cheese can carry me through the mid game, so I'm going to go a little bit later game in my build.
Yeah, we'll see whether it works as Sudden Fear looking to set up some vision around this dragon that they did manage to take the first time, but 14 seconds to go and immunity are all in position. Teleports available for both of our top laners. Christmas Trees is hanging around. Sudden Fear looking to have a little bit of control. Christmas Trees finds his way in. Brawler looking to threaten with that rocket grab. Does throw it out, but doesn't quite make it. Actually, the top lane turret gonna fall here as JK Smithy puts on a lot of pressure. Christmas Tree's building rage on the dragon yet again. You can see that bar filling up and filling up. We'll see whether he can actually land some of these boomerangs, make sure that he gets the evolution at the right time. And immunity, they're respecting it.
Yeah, I mean, they have to as well. Sudden Fear's time is now as far as their comp goes. They've got decent damage from Realnomicon with APAP. Infinity had just got completed, and Christmas Trees is very strong right now. So no one can get picked off. And honestly, JK Smithy's teleporting, but I don't know if they should contest here.
Yeah, they are coming through. The stun lands immediately. There's the hook onto JK Smithy. The Dominus has been popped. Christmas Trees right in amongst it, trying to get it down. The damage coming through. Fate's calling. The T-Gun gets him out of trouble. Uberbro coming through, trying to get something to happen, but no one's dead quite yet, and so much has happened.
I mean, lots of cooldowns traded back and forth, but immunity have no tank left here with Renekton getting low, but Sudden Fear have to be careful of Kassadin as well, for immunity just going to counter push instead.
Yeah, they're going for the flank, but you can see Christmas Tree so low, Cheese just kills him outright with a Rift Walk. Beautifully played, 4-1 now on this Kassadin, who has a needlessly large rod.
Yeah, Mininar just caught out of position against the Kassadin with no magic resist. Kassadin's going to kill you every single time, so immunity very patient there. Sudden Fear took, at least Christmas just took maybe the lazy way across back to his mid lane turret, and he got punished for it.
Yeah, I think we call that a see you later, see you bye, see ya.
I think so too.
Yeah, here around the office, but Cutie Cheese, all the kills for his team now stacked up. And if you're immunity, I mean, normally in a game like this, you're like, oh man, I wish the kills were distributed differently, but putting them all on a Kassadin? Oh, heck yeah, you take that every day of the week.
I mean, yeah, Immunity have a two-threat comp here, so they're fine if the Kassadin's the one holding all the kills. Again, a great Rod of Aegis timing and a very quick Rod here as well. to move in for what I assume is going to be a fast Sonya's. And again, it's reflected in the way Uber Bro is building. He's going to be a bit more patient. And Cheese can do all the carrying for this mid-game especially.
In fact, I think that Cheese just likes to build those two items on every champion that he plays.
I think you're right.
That's his standard Swain build and his standard Kassadin build coming through. Really, really nicely done. Of course, doesn't build it on his Xerath, so that sort of breaks my entire theory, but is going to be the blue buff. Going over to Apaps here in the mid lane as he still tries to defend that outer turret. Has kept that CS advantage here at about the same point moving forward, so now has sort of enough in order to just remove these waves as they come towards his turret.
Yeah, I mean, there's a decent wave clear over on the IM side here as well. I mean, Xerath as well is no slouch there, so it's fine. Immunity wave clear is a lot better going forward than backwards, so if they can keep being aggressive and get deep vision down, that's sort of where they want to be. And I'm curious to see that JK Smithy has gone for the Ghost Blade yet again here. If he's doing this, I imagine he's A, confident that Cheese is able to really control space in this game because of how big he is right now on Kassadin, but I assume he's going to stay in his lane for a bit longer and just try and tie Christmas trees up.
Pink Bomi may have been caught out just a little bit as Tegon tries to protect his ward. Does dodge out of the way of that Sonic Wave, so he's going to be A-okay. Roller threatening, though, in this Boom Boom Blitzcrank. Not quite finding it. Scrying Orb does spot him out, though, and Immunity are doing really, really well playing around this Blitzcrank. And you have to think that has a lot to do with Tegon knowing almost everything about that champion.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if they need to practice, Immunity have plenty of time to practice playing against Blitzcrank if Tegon maybe threatened to 1v1 them or something in the team speak. But I mean, they're respecting Rangers, but JK Smith, you're going to get caught out here.
Yeah, it's actually Christmas Tree is about to evolve. There's the Gnar into the wall. The Wallop going to stun him up here as well as JK Smith. He slices and dices, but a Pink Bomi, he's going to get it. No, he's not. Not this time. The Flash held onto for so long. A Pink Bomi looking for it. And no, it doesn't quite land. And JK Smith, I think he's immortal.
He might be. I mean, that's, what, how many times that they've gone in? And a great combo here again. I think he actually, oh, he did. He got kicked out of, sorry, he got hooked out of the wallop there.
My
Which didn't
gosh.
Complete the CC chain. I thought they'd put it
I
together
thought he
perfectly.
Hit it. Yeah, but no. Oh, dear.
And unfortunately for Sudden Fear, the last time they went there, they comboed beautifully and couldn't kill Renekton. Pink Bomi just a little hesitant to pull the trigger on the flash Q, and it cost him that kill against Renekton.
Yeah, Napaps did manage to land a slow here in the mid side, so I mean they get at least something for it. His Cheese looking very tanky now that he's finished that Zhonya's Hourglass. He's just going to rip walk right on top of Energizer. It's a nice spell shield. Zhonya's going to be used just to dodge out of the way of the extra damage. Now Konopol's going to find T-Gun here as well. They clear out the ward. Immunity going to be okay, but I think they took the worst side of that trade.
I mean, this is the great thing about Zhonya's Kassadin, is that you can just initiate with impunity by aggressive rift-walking Brawler, though.
Speaking of initiating, Zahi goes so aggressive onto Brawler, gets grabbed, and he is dead. T-Gun now going to come in. Force Pulse is going to be enough to get rid of that annoying Blitzcrank. Christmas Trees is very low. A Pink Bomi, he's okay, though. And Sudden Fear, they'll take the one for one.
Yeah, I mean, they'll collect the gold here, but Immunity are just really strong-arming Sudden Fear here. They're going to take another turret now, 3-1, and Kalista is roaming across the map with her team, so we'll see again. Zahi does go in, and that's almost getting a kill into Brawler, but just gets CC'd to death here. T-Gun tries to flash ult in to save him. Cheese, very cute. They'd managed to get the kill in the low health support, but this is the thing. Like, Sudden Fear have so much CC, it's just a matter of using it correctly.
Yeah, and I'm not sure why a Pink Bomi is up here on the top side, because we know now, JK Smithy is impossible to kill. Stop trying. There is no point. Cheese, here on the bottom side, just going to be split pushing the... Now that he can, because of course, so strong on this Kassadin at this stage. And that Force Ball's going to be able to clear out these waves as well. Boomerang's just trying to come through from Energizer just to clear this one out, make sure that they can't get too much damage down on this tower. There's not a lot of Siege coming through from Immunity, so if they can use this Sivir effectively, they can extend this game for a long time.
They can, but you made the best possible point there about Immunity. They don't have good Siege, so what they're doing is actually what Papa Smithy mentioned in their last game today against Chiefs. They had the option of split pushing and didn't take it against the Chiefs. Now, with the way JK Smith is building, they're actually committing to 1-1-3 and pushing every single laner because they know they're strong enough. Kassadin can be practically anywhere on the map, and Kalista's really good at any sort of small skirmish or duel. So if they keep splitting Sudden Fear up, all of the CC that they have between Blitz, Lee Sin, and Gnar just never gets used the way they want it to.
Yeah, and they've got incredibly high tower damage as well, what with, you know, Ghost Blade Renekton, and Kassadin, he's no slouch. He does a lot of damage with that Q reset. I mean, with the W reset.
Jeez, maybe looking to go in again, but again, just going to kind of love tap Pink Bomi there. And Dragon is going to be up soon. I imagine that's why Immunity are grouping up. But even JK Smithy, going for Sunfire Cape this time, he kind of recognized that the Ghostblade, maybe not what he, like, when he didn't push, wasn't that good. So he's fully committing to split pushing now.
Yeah, I mean, interesting sort of second buy to come through. You have to think that a Randuin's might be a little bit better, but just wants his power now as Cheese going to find Brawler. There's the flash flagon drag, but doesn't get the knockup. The Cataclysm immediately kicked out of it as Cheese is going to kill Brawler. Then use the Zonyas, and he is still at full health. The Pink Bomi has the option of coming back in. Christmas Tree's about to evolve, but not going to take the opportunity. Has Dragon up in 1 second, and Brawler just died.
And so much credit to Zahi there as well. He's done so much work for this team. He's basically the only real person that can effectively pick someone off in this team, with maybe Cheese with a Riftwalk slow being an exception there. But he's the hard engage. Zahi, with his sight stones getting so much vision, he's made so many picks happen already.
Yeah, and Immunity waiting out that Meganar as well, as APAP's going down so incredibly low. Uber Bro picks up the kill with a Renset. And Immunity continue the chase. The inner turret is there. Sudden Fear going to be okay, but that's another Dragon now for Immunity. They are taking control of the objectives and getting the picks when they want to. Speaking of picks, not going to happen.
Yeah, Tegan a little too fast there on the Janna, so we'll dodge the Blitz Hook there. And Immunity again, I assume they're going to go back in and start split pushing. JK Smithy already moving in towards the top lane. Jeez, actually might 1v1 Christmas Trees here.
Looking for it. Brawler's coming around, wants some revenge on this Kassadin, but doesn't quite get it before the Rift walks there. Rocket Grab not going to find him either, or a Scuttle Crab, which is a little bit unfortunate because it's always funny grabbing those Scuttle Crabs from across the wall. But not going to find it. Sudden Fear, they're still looking for that fight, that wonder fight that they want.
And Immunity aren't going to give it to them. They just grouped for the Dragon, but got a pick to make sure they secured it. And to be honest, if they lost it, they probably wouldn't be too upset about it. Instead, JK Smithy back to pushing. Uber Bro just dodges
what?
That hook.
That was almost like he was groping Uber Bro there a little bit, but doesn't quite grab him. And Uber Bro and T-Gun going to continue to go aggressively forward just because they know that they're so safe.
I mean, you can see how much work this Hurricane's doing now as well with the Blade. Pretty much any major lifesteal item in Hurricane's good on Kalista. Blade, again, the less safe and aggressive choice, but just is a lot smoother as far as item builds go. But that was basically 2v4 between T-Gun and Uber Bro. They were happy to take on Sudden Fear.
More than happy. And as soon as Brawler misses that hook as well, I mean, they sort of lose a lot of their options as far as getting these fights started in the way that they want to. Zaki going to take down the Scuttle Crab. Cheese just coming through. They're trying to clear out all of these wards. And now just Immunity with so much control over this game. And that is, it's just so methodical as well. And you have to think Immunity, this emotional team, this team that runs a lot on momentum. This isn't necessarily their style, but it's looking fantastic.
Yeah, and we could have said that about the game against Chiefs as well. And for the first 20 minutes, they were playing to the comp strength.
Yeah.
Immunity this time really committing to their win conditions properly this time. And, you know, they're just going to take things slow. They don't want what happened against the Chiefs to happen again here. And they've got so much control of this game. And you mentioned Blitzcrank here. Who is Brawler realistically going to hook in this game? Tanky Renekton, Tanky Jarvan, Kassadin they can get out, Janna can get Fates Called, or the Kalista and then Janna peels for her. There are no good targets here for Brawler's Blitz.
Yeah, it's awful. And I think it has to be Uber Bro, but you're right. I mean, then they're inviting themselves to get Force Pulsed all to death almost instantly by Cheese with impunity.
I mean, T-Gun can peel off there if that happens as well, and then he can pull T-Gun out with Fates Call. Like, Kalista is good because she's bonding with her support, so when you have a high, heavy disengage and peel support bonded to your Kalista, she just stays alive forever.
Oh, yeah. But Immunity now, they're going to start the Baron. Of course, Uber Bro with a lot of damage with that Blade of the Ruined King and the Hurricane shredding through the health bar. Look at the amount of spears stuck in the head of this big serpent man as a Pink Bomi is going to come round. They're looking for the engage of Sudden Fear. But look at the Baron. It's down to 2,000 health. He's not going to be able to steal that because Kalista does so much damage to Baron. And Sudden Fear, they just have to watch the Baron die.
Yeah, Zahi actually didn't even have smite. Oh, no, he did, sorry. It was a smite charge there. But yeah, about 2,500.
He didn't need to use it.
About 2,500 health was a secure there on that Baron. So pretty insane stuff from Kalista.
Not bad at all. There's a Riftwalk to come through. Gets a Force Pulse onto a couple of members, does Cheese. As Sudden Fear now, they're going to probably respect exactly what's going on. Is a Pink Bomi going to take away the Raptor, though? Of course, wants to get at least a little bit out of this one. They're going to be able to clear out some wards, but Sudden Fear now have to contend with a barrened up Immunity, trying to sort of help out the fact that their siege pretty non-existent.
I mean, Immunity, though, if they're going forward, especially with the Baron buff, doesn't really matter that their siege is pretty bad, like you mentioned. They're just happy to keep going in and being aggressive. And this is one of the things about Blitzcrank that's really interesting. For how good his hook is as a pick tool, Blitzcrank is really bad when your team's behind because you can't get vision to let him aggressively hook people.
Yeah, Chi's actually going to halve Brawler's health here as well by coming through with an aggressive Rift Walk. Of course, knowing the fact that that hook is on a very low cooldown. In fact, you could probably hear T-Gun in their team speak now, sort of saying something like, and it's got about 7 seconds to go, six, five, and now we have to respect it again. Because, of course, he knows it so incredibly well. This inner turret's going down incredibly quickly, though, in the mid lane. There's Christmas Trees. He might get engaged on Zahi, just looking to secure the turret. Sudden Fear now forced under their inhibitor turret. We'll see if they can turtle this one out, but at this stage, you have to think with the likes of Kalista, with the Kassadin as well, things are only going to get worse for Sudden Fear.
Yeah, and I like that you mentioned Kalista. I actually love Uberbro's build here. It might look weird to see him going for, assume that's a Phantom Dancer with what he's got currently, but again, it's all about smoothing out your power curve. And with how the game's going for Uberbro, he doesn't need a big power spike right now. He's keeping up already just on base stats and levels and ranks in Rend that he doesn't need an Infinity Edge. He'll get it probably as his fourth item here, and he'll go off when he gets it. But this is all about getting to your strong item build in the smoothest way possible. And Phantom Dancer does a good job, especially at dodging stuff like Blitzcrank hooks.
Yeah, and when you've got Janna as well, I mean, she's lacking a lot of flat damage. So with the Eye of the Storm, he's going to have the flat damage that he needs.
That's a great point. We see this a lot on champions like Twitch and anyone's like strong on hit effect, right? Vayne as well. You just want to maximize your attack speed and mobility because the damage part isn't really what does all the damage. It's the on-hit effect that you provide from your champion.
Oh, yeah. And the fact that just Uberbro's been so safe throughout this game, he sort of doesn't need to worry. He just wants to be stacking Rend as much as possible, using that Hurricane. And then, you know, JK Smithy's doing heaps of work. Cheese is doing heaps of work. I mean, Uberbro just needs to press E at the right times, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, Cheezer at this point is probably the best janitor immunity could ask for as team fights going. He's not even, he's kind of slowed down a little bit here on Kassadin. I mean, hasn't finished his next major item, which might even be a death cap, which would be absolutely insane as far as burst damage goes. But Sudden Fear, they had the comp that needed to get on the front foot early, and right now immunity have complete control of the map.
Yeah, this is going to be the third dragon going down very easily. A little bit more movement speed, which is going to make them very happy. And T-Gun just going to be a rocket around this map. He already has the Talisman of Ascension. He's building a Righteous Glory as well.
Yeah, why not? Just have all the movement speed. Make sure you can get to the fight first here, because that's what IAM's comp is all about. It is just mobility everywhere.
Oh, yeah. Now you've got Phantom Dancer as well as Boots 2 coming through from Uberbro. I mean, this guy's going to be moving super fast. And he's already Kalista. And you were right. I was saying it'd be ludicrous if he was to pick up a Death Cap instead of a Void Staff. But no, cheese. Picks it up.
Why? What do you really need Void Staff for at this point? There's one magic resist item that I can see. I guess there's an Aegis there as well, so that does actually make some difference. But Cheese is so far ahead at this point on Kassadin that he just wants to do enough damage. And the thing is, he wants to chunk whatever the furthest forward target is that he can get to. So if that's a tank, fine, it's a tank. They don't have that much MR anyway.
Yeah, doesn't matter. And of course, it actually augments his auto attacks against turrets as well. So for the split push, which as you mentioned is a thing that they're going to be looking for, going to be helping that all the more. But JK Smithy here on this top side. Sudden Fear have realized for the last little while that he's immortal, so they haven't been giving him too much trouble, but maybe have forgotten at this stage as there are four members up here. But I think they're just waiting for the immunity rotation, which is intelligent because it's exactly what they're doing.
Yeah, and again, with all the movement speed, immunity will get anywhere first before Sudden Fear, even though Sudden Fear confined to a much smaller area on the map. And I'm pretty sure JK Smithy hasn't left.
Oh my gosh, the flash over the sun! Apaps is ignited! The safeguard is going to be enough! Oh, the spear from Uberbro! Beautiful work! And Sudden Fear lose their mage. Uberbro now dancing, using the tower. Energizer's just going to die. Monsoon against the wall as Brawler gets caught up. A triple kill now. Could it be the Penta for Uberbro? He picks up the Quadra. Christmas Trees, it's a Penta kill for Uberbro.
And probably the easiest Penta kill that Uberbro will ever get in his life. His team handed that to him after such incredible initiation by Cheese and JK Smithy. And you know what, he'll take it, but to be honest, he did deserve it, but his team gave it to him.
Most definitely donated over there, but a beautiful rotational play by Immunity, and I just love it when pentakills happen, let's be honest.
I mean, we'll see it again here. Cheese just goes in, but this spear is amazing there by Kalista. So there's the first kill. Brawler misses his hook there as well, and Cheese just dives in, knows the target. He wants to go straight in onto Energizer. Uberbro just hops in. Cheese happily tanks the tower, and look at this. Jarvanel getting put down, JK Smithy going off, and it's just the easiest pentakill of take of Uberbro's life here. Good Fates call as well, actually knocks up Christmas Trees to secure it, and again, his team happily gifted that over to Kalista, and that's what she does when she gets a Snowball's a team fight. And Immunity didn't need much more than that, but he'll take the Pentakill.
Yeah, that was beautiful to see. And that was a 1-1-0 Kalista as well. Just picking up a Pentakill, no problem at all. And I think I'm going to be building a Phantom Dancer every time because that gets you a Pentakill.
I'm thinking about it more as well. Remember that Kalista's passive does scale from movement speed as well.
Yeah.
So having more movement speed makes it easy for you to hop around these fights. And again, same sort of theory. As long as you're applying Rend on Kalista, you're probably doing enough damage. So the fact that crit's a semi-wasted stat in this build just doesn't matter as much, because all you really want is to keep auto-attacking people.
Yeah, it gives you the opportunity to build a last item. Oh my gosh, Cheese is just going to destroy Apaps. Energizer going to try and run. On the Hunt is named wrong because he's using it to get the hell out of here. Cheese has Zhonya's. He's going to be not safe. Although he didn't... there it is. To dodge the boomerang. That is just so cheeky, Cheese. But Immunity going to continue this one out. And they managed to get a couple of picks, but it looks like they are not going to be able to transition it into too much. Of course, the wave's now pushing out here for Sudden Fear. And they're going to try and make something happen. Cheese now just going to back away, head back to base. And Immunity's just not going to be able to do too much with this.
Yeah, if we can, maybe... fault Immunity for something here in this game. It's kind of poor sidewave control, actually. It's funny that we'd mentioned that, like, given how much 1-3-1 split pushing they've been doing, but JK Smithy decided to leave the top lane at some point
what?
In this game.
That's ludicrous.
I'm just as surprised as you are, but when that happens, Sudden Fear actually pushed the wave back in, so Immunity can't get anything but at least take the baron.
Yeah, but it's at half health at this stage. Uber Bro, though, stabbing it with spears, going to be able to be very difficult to steal. Just, okay, that was about 4,000 health. That is disgusting. And the Scuttle Crab going to die as well. And then right at the Arcane came through, and I was like, oh, yeah, he's going to get... No, wait, hang on, Kalista.
No, yeah, you just can't really out-secure objectives like a Kalista can. Rend just does so much damage against monsters because you're able to stack up the Rend. You know, Zai was in there with his smite as well. So a very smart Baron there. Immunity, even if they'd lost the Baron, would have at least loved to force a team fight. So they're fine with what's going on. They've got an unbelievably massive gold advantage at this point, and they just kind of finished the game at their own leisure at this point.
Yeah, it's true. And this Kalista now has 2.3 attack speed, so very, very close to that cap. Rocket Grab not going to find its markers, neither is that slow. Arcana Pulse going to find T-Gun. T-Gun just sort of doesn't really mind about taking damage because he's T-Gun.
I mean, again, he's safe. Kalista also will keep him there as well. They're going to pop the Ascension.
Yeah, the Ascension comes through as Christmas Tree is getting caught up. And look at JK Smithy getting the damage onto Apaps. A double kill now for the Crocodile. Is it his turn for the Penta? I don't think so, because the Inhibitor Turret, that's going to be the focus. Zahi tries to turn it around again. The Boomerang to come through. Energizer took half of his health from that Q. The Null Sphere from Cheese, that is just ridiculous. Zahi very, very low on health, tanking up the turret a little bit, unfortunately. Cheese gonna use the Zhonya's. Is Riftwalk gonna be there? I'm not sure. No, not gonna be enough, as it's gonna be Energizer picking up that kill. One turret is dead, but two inhibitors down now as well, as Sudden Fear somehow managed to hold onto their base for this moment.
Yeah, just a bit too aggressive by Immunity, but look at the red minions down. Immunity have really not been trimming their garden as far as sidewaves go here, but they're gonna take away the blue. They'll get the dragon that's up in a few seconds as well. Losing a tier 2, not great, but they'll take it at this point because they're just so far ahead.
Well, no, I'm pretty sure that Immunity have sort of messed up the resolution on their monitors at the moment, because they haven't seen sort of the bottom to the right area of the map.
No, not yet. I mean, it's funny. They've just been stuck in mid lane for so long, just trying to get kills. Again, it's arguably a little greedy. Maybe they got the first Penta, like, we need more Pentakills.
Yeah.
Trying to set an OPL record for number of Pentakills in one game, maybe. T-Gun, for some reason, hasn't magized. I don't think it matters too much at this point. And Immunity, again, with a massive lead, Sudden Fear, you're going to have to dig very deep to try and defend from this one.
Yeah, I don't know why T-Gun's got a Magize, because he only wants items that are giving him heaps and heaps of movement speed, and that doesn't give him heaps of movement speed.
Well, I think he maybe ran out of items in the shop to buy that give him more speed here.
Phantom Dancer?
He could have bought Phantom
what
Dancer.
What an idiot.
I would have loved a Zeke's, actually. That wouldn't have been the worst thing ever. Uber, or even Banner of Command.
Yeah.
It's actually quite good, given that, again, they don't need to break the base anymore, I guess, given that they're kind of broken already, but... Immunity feeling pretty good at this game. JK Smithy is unbelievably tanky. This is the Renekton that he missed in the Chiefs game.
Oh, yeah. Has got to that point where he's got Thornmail and the Sunfire Cape here as well. The Inhibitor just going to be waited for, as Immunity just going to destroy it as soon as it comes home. That was a really tough visit. As here's the fight. The Cataclysm to start it off. Only one Nexus turret fighting the members of Immunity, because Sudden Fear are all back into the fountain. They turn around and turn it onto the Inhibitor. I mean, onto the Nexus turret. A nice knock up there from T-Gun, but JK Smithy taking a lot of damage. The Immortal God, is he going to fall? No, look at the dancing shoes on this Crocodile. He is incredible. A Sudden Fear are starting to get low, but JK Smithy, what are you doing, buddy? Get out of there.
I mean, he really wants to get some more kills. I think he's jealous of Uberbro's pentakill here. Uberbro's taking his time killing this Nexus because he is Kalista, but Christmas Tree is going to get caught. Cheese will get the kill, and that should be enough for immunity.
Yep, JK Smithy continuing to walk around the heel just to make sure that they're okay as the Nexus falls down. And GG, well played to Team Immunity. They looked fantastic in that game.
Yeah, hilariously, Kassadin actually had to kill the Nexus because as cool as Uberbro's build was, it doesn't have any real flat AD, especially without Gyno Shield. So he's kind of huffing spears into the Nexus, and she's like, okay, I got this, buddy. Don't worry about it. Enjoy your pentakill, and I'll get the Nexus.
Yeah, he'd managed to take care of the actual business. You have to think that Cheese sort of hard carrying that game, especially early on. Having sort of going for that exchange, getting the one for one was like, oh, okay, we'll see whether he's going to be okay. And then just the double kill and the beautiful cleanup was great. So let's see a replay from this match. Let's see how Immunity did it.
Yeah, so we'll roll this out here. And Immunity at this point are really far ahead, but Cheese here catches Paps here, does so much damage. Uberbro again comes in with the snipe. So watch how well Immunity set up the rest of this here. Cheese dives immediately onto the ADK. Uberbro is hopping around the turret, using his martial poise to get him deeper into the fight. And then it's all tanking here from the Renekton and Jarvan. Really, again, didn't need much more from this, but Uru played that very well to make sure to secure the last few kills. I loved that he hopped around using structures to get closer and closer in, but and Cheese set it up perfectly for him. And at that point, like you mentioned, just an unbelievably fed Kassadin.
Yeah, and it was only moments before that we were discussing the fact that he has this Phantom Dancer, and what is he going to do? He's just going to get E onto people and just rend them up. And what did he do? He pressed E at the right times in a team fight and got a pentakill. So that is just perfect.
Yeah, that's exactly how you play Kalista. You want to get into fights, you want to start snowballing them. Kassadin's a great champion to do that with because he does so much flat damage in an AoE. And Uberbro, again, I said easiest pentakill of his life. He'll take it. He doesn't care.
Oh, absolutely. But ladies and gentlemen, we still have one more match coming up for you this evening. It's going to be Direwolves taking on Sudden Fear. And we'll see whether Sudden Fear can come back from this difficult one. We know they can do it. We'll see.